beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east, the master bedroom where the vampires feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. The guest included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
Hello everyone, Dr. Perkins here with October Messages. Thank you so much for joining me. That song was The Monster Mash by Bobby Boris Pickett, produced in 1962. Hopefully you enjoyed it. All right, it is Hispanic Heritage Month. And that runs from September 15th through October 15th. We will have many guest speakers this month and incorporate the beauty of the Hispanic culture into many lessons. We will also recognize Native American Month, which is next month in November, and Black History Month in February. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. I'm just having some fun with that title. Our homecoming was last week. We really appreciate the administration and the high school team for sticking it out, working a lot of long hours to make homecoming week a true success. Thank you very, very much. The junior class won this year's homecoming float contest, and you'll see their float in a few seconds. Congratulations to them. Second place was the sophomore class with their Pac-Man float. The theme, I should mention, was 1980s video game. Rounding out the back end was third place, the freshman class, and the fourth place went to the seniors. Come on, seniors, what happened? Congratulations to the junior class. Gate fees at the sporting events, thank you governing board, are now $2. They've been reduced significantly from $5 to $2. So this is yet another reason to come out and enjoy your monsters during the sporting events. Free admission will be for students and for kids birth through age 18 and staff members. All right, let's transition into what I call the statement of apology. Friday night, September 23rd versus Orm, our homecoming game. We had some misconduct incidents at the end of the game from some of our coaches, players, and parents. Those incidents do not represent the Gila Unified School District. We want to apologize. We have talked to those people, and there were consequences given, and we will move forward in a positive manner. But we, again, want to apologize for those incidents. That is not us. We will always strive to be a professional and classy organization. Please continue to come out and support your monsters, and let's all of us move forward positively. Thank you. Moving on to October events. Save these dates. September 30th, end of the first grading period. Please encourage your kids to end on a strong note. October 4th through 7th, fall break. Yay, I'm sure the kids will love that. No school. October 11th, our monthly board meeting, 6:30 start time in our governing boardroom, just off the library. October 12th, we will have our monthly fire and lockdown drills. October 12th and 13th, 12th and 13th, half days, we will have our first quarter parent-teacher conferences, October 12th and 13th. Early dismissal for lower grades at 12:30, for the upper grades 6 through 12 at 1:30. And October 14th, I should mention, report cards will be given out at the parent-teacher conferences. If for some reason parents miss the parent-teacher conferences, hopefully you will not, we will send home with students on October 14th the report cards. Family reading night is right around the corner. We want to give you a heads up. And that will be November 9th. And that's from 5:30 to 8:30 in our library. And this is for pre-K through third grade parents. Again, pre-K through third grade parents, family reading night. We're going to have a lot of activities as far as on the literacy side. We're actually partnering up with the Arizona Learning Institute for this event. So please come on out, make it a family night. Again, you will learn a lot of literacy activities to take home and have some literacy fun that night. All are welcome, pre-K through three. We hope to see you there. All right, let's talk about our last message here. Every vote truly does count, and we encourage you to get involved in the voting process. You can go to servicearizona.com to register if you're not registered. Items you would need to register while you're on that site are your Social Security number, your Arizona driver's license number, and this is optional if you fall into this category, your tribal ID and or alien registration number. You must be a U.S. citizen, an Arizona resident, and you must be 18 on or before the election date, which is November 8th. The registration deadline is Monday, October 10th. And then early voting starts Wednesday, October 12th. We encourage you to get involved. Every vote truly does count. Thank you everyone for listening. This will do it for the October messages. Have a great month. We'll see you back here next month.